cover with brown paper so that we can prevent from getting paint all on this edge. And then when we come back and paint the wall, this edge will be full of paint and it'll bleed through the finish coat on the walls. He's gonna go around to the other side and start spraying the other side of the door frame.
Thank you.
can see, he's only around 6 inches of distance away from the frame. He's taking a second look at it. You can see the fine finish that the HVLP leaves as it starts to dry. That pressure pot right there in his hand, he's able to maneuver the gun in different directions. If he had the pressure pot, if he had the cup gun connected to the pressure pot, he would have more trouble to do different maneuvers, to be able to spray in different directions, upwards, downwards. He would probably just be able to spray up and down or side to side. Y'all enjoy this video. If at any given time you enjoy this video, please smash that like button. If you're not subscribed to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. Also, don't forget to leave comments down in the comment section of more content that y'all would like to see, whether it's got to do with tape floating, texturing, or painting, or if y'all enjoy this video or other techniques that y'all might have used to spray the door frames or paint the hollow metal frames, whether y'all would have used the HVLP or y'all would have used a smaller airless.